Look at the first question. Find Fourier transform of f of t is equal to e raised to minus a into modulus of t for minus infinity less than t less than infinity, where a is positive. See here, the function is f of t is equal to e raised to minus a into modulus of t. Okay, mod function. Now, you are asked to find the Fourier transform. So, you can use the definition of Fourier transform. So, write the, so whenever we have these types of questions, the first thing that you have to do is write the definition, okay, of Fourier transform. So, Fourier transform by the definition, f of t is equal to 1 by root 2 pi integral minus infinity to infinity f of t into e raised to minus I omega t into dt. Now, what is the function f of t? F of t is e raised to minus a into modulus of t, right? And it is given, look at the interval also. Whenever you are doing these type of questions, look at the interval. It is given in the end, the whole interval, minus infinity to infinity. So, single interval enough. So, 1 by root 2 pi integral minus infinity to infinity f of t, the value of f of t, that is e raised to minus a into modulus of t into e raised to minus I omega t dt. Now, how to integrate this function? That is the next question. So you are given e raised to minus a into modulus function. See, you have to remember the definition of mod function. Okay, so what is mod function? See, modulus of t takes two different values. It takes minus t for t less than 0 and t for t greater than 0. See the definition of mod function, modulus of t. See, modulus of t, it takes minus t for t less than 0, for all the negative values, and it is modulus of t equal to t for the positive values of t. Okay, so this interval minus infinity to infinity you can split. How? From minus infinity to 0, that means for t less than 0, and from 0 to infinity. So in such a manner, I am splitting this integral into two integrals. One is from minus infinity to 0 and the other is from 0 to infinity. Now, you have to write the value of f of t or e raised to minus a modulus of t in these two cases. See, what is the value of e raised to minus a modulus of t in the interval from minus infinity to 0? Minus infinity to 0 means t less than 0. In t less than 0, modulus of t will be minus t. So, when you are writing modulus of t, the value, it is minus t. Already we have a negative sign. So, minus a into minus t. Okay, so that is why it reduces to e raised to a t into e raised to minus I omega t into dt. See, is it clear? Remember the definition of mod t. Mod t is minus t for t less than 0. You have to take this one first. So, here we considered minus infinity to 0 and mod t will be minus t. Already one minus sign, hence it is positive. So, e raised to a t into e raised to minus I omega t dt. I think you got the result. Okay, now look at the second integral. It is from 0 to infinity. What about in this interval? 0 to infinity. What is the value of mod t? It is t. Okay, for t greater than 0, mod t is t. Okay, so this is positive. Mod t is t. Therefore, e raised to minus a into t. That is e raised to minus a itself. Into e raised to minus omega t into dt. Now, the integration process. Now, we have to combine these exponential functions. How will you combine these two exponential? E raised to a t into e raised to minus I omega t. When you are combining, you can see the result. E raised to a raised to m into a raised to n. It is a raised to m plus n. So, use that result. So, this is e raised to a minus, see, t is common. So, I am taking t here. E raised to a minus I omega into t dt plus integral 0 to infinity. E raised to, here also t is common and negative sign is also common. So, you can then take minus sign outside. So, e raised to minus of a plus omega I into t dt. Now, the next step is integration. e raised to ax on integrating, it is e raised to ax by a. Okay, so by using that result, 1 by root 2 pi e raised to a minus I omega into t divided by a minus I omega. The coefficient should be divided. Okay. And this is with limit minus infinity to 0. And the second term, it is e raised to minus of a plus I omega t divided by minus of a plus I omega, and that is having limit 0 to infinity. Now for the first term, you have to substitute upper limit and lower limit. What is happening when you are substituting upper limit? You just see the term. E raised to, see in the place of t, when you are substituting 0, this is e raised to 0. E raised to 0, answer is 1. So it is 1 by a minus I omega. I'm putting upper limit. And what will be the lower limit? You are substituting t is equal to minus infinity, right? So when you are putting t is equal to minus infinity, this is e raised to minus infinity. I told you in the earlier video, whenever we have e raised to minus infinity, that can be replaced by 0. Okay, so on putting lower limit, the value will be 0. Okay, so hence we have only 1 by a minus I omega. Now for the second term, you substitute upper limit infinity. When you are substituting upper limit infinity, it will be e raised to minus infinity again, that is 0. And then the lower limit for t, you substitute 0. So e raised to 0 divided by minus of a plus I omega. Say for substituting lower limit, already we have a negative sign and one more negative sign here. So that 2 get cancelled. We have a by 1 by a minus I omega plus 1 by a plus I omega. Now you just combine this. So on cross multiplication, we have a plus I omega plus a minus I omega and minus I omega get cancelled. A plus a, it is 2a. So in total, the Fourier transform of the given function is 1 by root 2 pi into 2a divided by a square plus omega square. How this becomes a square plus omega square? See, the LCM is a minus I omega into a plus I omega. See, this is of the form sum a plus ib, a plus b into a minus b. A plus b into a minus b is a square minus b square. So here we have a square minus I omega the whole square. I omega the whole square, what is I square? I square is minus 1. Therefore, we have a square minus of minus omega square. So that's why we have a square plus omega square. So this is the final answer. That is, see the final answer, it is a function of omega. So that's why we denoted the Fourier transform by f of omega. Okay. Now the second question, find the Fourier transform of f of t is equal to 1 for mod t less than 1 and 0 otherwise. Here f of t, you are given f of t in a split up form based on the value of t, that means mod t less than 1. What do you mean by mod t less than 1? Already we discussed in one of the video. Mod t less than 1 means t lies between minus 1 and plus 1, minus 1 to 1. So when t lies between minus 1 to 1, f of t takes the value 1 and 0 otherwise. You are asked to find the Fourier transform. So I told you the first step is writing the definition of Fourier transform. So by the definition, f of t is equal to 1 by root 2 pi integral minus infinity to infinity f of t into e raised to minus I omega t dt. Now you substitute the value of f of t. See, f of t can be write directly 1 having the same limit minus infinity to infinity? No. It is given in a split up. So you have to split the integral to different integrals, and except from minus 1 to 1, all other integral values are zeros, isn't it? Since you are given 0 otherwise. So we are having, we should write only the integral from minus 1 to 1. Okay. So 1 by root 2 pi integral from minus 1 to 1 f of t. If t takes values between minus 1 to 1, what is the value of f of t? F of t is 1. It is given in the question. So 1 into a raised to minus I omega t into dt. Right? So 1 by root 2 pi into, now you just integrate this function, e raised to minus I omega t on integration, you divide the coefficient. Okay, so e raised to minus I omega t divided by minus I omega with the limits minus 1 to 1. Now you substitute upper limit and then the lower limit. So 1 by root 2 pi n2 e raised to, so when you are putting t is equal to 1, it is a raised to I omega divided by minus I omega plus, now lower limit it is minus 1. So as we are, when we are putting t is equal to minus 1, it is a raised to I omega divided by I omega. So I omega, since it is a common factor, so common denominator, you can combine these two terms. So by writing 1 by root 2 pi into e raised to I omega minus e raised to minus I omega divided by I omega. Okay. Now what I did is, I made an adjustment here. See, since we have a result, see this result, e raised to I omega minus e raised to minus I omega divided by 2. See, you have learned earlier in first semester this result. This is equal to I into sine omega. So keep in mind this result, this is very important. Okay. Sine omega, or you can write sine omega, one definition in terms of the exponential. Okay, this is actually the complex exponential. So e raised to I omega minus e raised to minus I omega divided by 2i. You can write if you want 2i, that is sine omega. So using this, we want to use this result here. So for doing that, what I did is, I multiplied this by 2 and divided this by 2. Okay, so e raised to I omega minus e raised to minus I omega by 2. This can be replaced by, what is that, I sine omega. So in total this becomes, okay, one more thing I did is, see we had a term 1 by I. 1 by I, keep in mind this result. 1 by I is equal to minus I. This also you have to learn. 1 by I. And in detail, we will discuss these types of the properties based on complex functions. We will discuss in complex analysis. Okay, so for the time being, you just understand the formula. 1 by I is equal to minus I. So, this also I replaced. 1 by I wrote here 1 by I as minus I. Okay, so minus I divided by root 2 pi into 1 by omega as it is. 2 as it is, and this is replaced by I sine omega, that's all. Now we have a 2 divided by root 2, isn't it? 2 divided by root 2, and one more thing, I into I. I into I, what is it? I square. And what is that if I square? This also I think you have learned in higher secondary, I square is minus 1. In higher secondary section, you might have learned I square as minus 1. So, and already one negative sign here. So, minus of minus, it is positive. That's why this is, okay, divided by root 2 and into root 2 we have. So, it can be further simplified as root 2. And the denominator we have root pi. So, I combined this as root of 2 by pi. And the remaining is sine omega divided by omega. So, this is the Fourier transform of the given function f of t. Equal to 1 for model t less than 1 and 0 otherwise, and this is very important question. Okay. Now the third question. Find f of x for f of x is equal to e raised to minus ax for x greater than 0 and f of x equal to 0 for x less than 0 and a is positive. And here instead of giving f of t, you are given f of x. Okay. Then you are asked to find f of x, that means the Fourier transform of f of x. Now we use the definition. Okay, f of t. So you can write a f of x or f of t, any form. F of t, we have a sense, we have learned in this form, I wrote in the same way. 1 by root 2 pi integral minus infinity to infinity f of t into e raised to minus I omega t dt. Now what is f of t? Directly can we write e raised to minus at having the same limit minus infinity to infinity? No. You are given f of t in two different forms. One is from minus infinity to 0 and other is from 0 to infinity. See, you just see this f of x for x greater than 0 and f of x for x less than 0. So when you are splitting the single integral to two integrals, the first integral vanishes. Most of the value of the first integral will be 0. And now we have only from integral from 0 to infinity. From 0 to infinity, what is the value of f of t? It is e raised to minus at into e raised to minus I omega t dt. Now you combine the exponential. So 1 by root 2 pi into integral 0 to infinity, e raised to minus sin is common, so it can be taken outside. So minus of a plus I omega t into dt. Now you have to integrate this. Okay, exponential on integrating 1 by root 2 pi into e raised to minus of a plus I omega t divided by minus of a plus I omega. Remember, coefficient should be divided, having the limit 0 to infinity. And in this question also, when you are substituting the upper limit, it takes the value e raised to minus infinity. See, when you are putting t is equal to infinity, this is e raised to minus this into infinity. In total, it is e raised to minus infinity and the value will be 0. So, upper limit 0, minus of this minus, it is plus. Lower limit, t is equal to 0, when you are substituting, it is e raised to 0. E raised to 0 is 1. So, 1 divided by a plus I omega. Therefore, the total answer is 1 by root 2 pi into 1 divided by a plus I omega. This is the Fourier transform of the given function f of x. Now, one of the important questions is, what is the sufficient condition for the existence of this Fourier transform? And this is very important. Let us examine what are the sufficient conditions. Sufficient condition for existence of Fourier transform. There are two conditions. The first condition is f of t is piecewise continuous on minus infinity to infinity. This statement already we discussed in the previous video. So f of t, the first statement is the first sufficient condition for the existence is f of t is piecewise continuous on the entire interval from minus infinity to infinity. If you are considering f of t should be piecewise continuous. This may have some discontinuous points. Okay. And the second statement is f of t is absolutely integrable on x-axis. So what do you mean by absolutely integrable? The integral should converge. See the integral. Which integral should converge? Integral minus infinity to infinity. Modulus of f of t into dt. This is less than infinity. Less than infinity means finite. Finite means convergent. Okay. So the second statement is f of t is absolutely integrable on x-axis. So these are the two statements for the existence of Fourier transform. So today what we discussed here. See, we just revised what is a Fourier transform of a function f of t. And then we did few questions based on this concept. And in the last section, I discussed the existence of the sufficient condition for the existence of Fourier transform. I hope you all understood these topics, today's topics. In the next class, we will discuss on Fourier sine and cosine transform. Okay? Thank you very much.